Hi, it's Reese from Cranbourne Music here, and today we're checking out the new Rumble series of amps from Fender. So the Rumble series has been around for a while now, but this recent rendition from Fender has been renewed with quite a few new features, but also kind of an old school kind of vibe and an old school kind of look. In the series, there are six amplifiers, of which today we have four. We have the Rumble 15, we have the Rumble 25, we have the Rumble 40, and the one which I'm plugged into right there is the Rumble 100. That is currently being mic'd up with a X1 from SE Electronics. Today I'll be playing a Fender American Standard Jazz Bass in black with a maple fingerboard. On the amp, if we zoom in on there, we're all flat to start with in the EQ section. Quite a few tonal options in the Rumble 100, which is the one again that we're plugged into. The vintage switch, which I'll demonstrate now. So that's without the vintage switch in. If I flick it in. So there's quite a bit of high-end roll-off and quite a bit of low-mid, that vintage kind of sound. The bright switch on. And this is without the bright switch. And then we have the contour switch. So the contour switch gives us a nice mid scoop for a more, I guess, modern sound. I like the vintage switch in, so we're going to put it in for the remainder of the video. Yeah. Everything's actually notched in the middle as well when you run it flat, which is kind of cool. So if you want to achieve, I guess, a bass sound with which to work from, you can just roll it around till you reach that notch. Everything's in the middle, nice and easy. And then if you want more treble, you just add it in. Quite noticeable. Hopefully it translates in YouTube land. Now we'll take a look at the overdrive section in the amp, which is a feature that the Rumble 40 and upwards has. Kick it in, it's got a nice bright red LED to let us know that the overdrive is on. The overdrive is also foot switchable. So that's with the drive not up that much, but I'll crank it up all the way now. You know what? I'm going to roll the tone off a little bit as well because it's a little bit squeaky. Overdrive actually is responding really well to the way I'm playing as well. If I dig in, it really gives us more drive. More of a more breakup and that kind of thing. And if I lay off a little bit, it kind of cleans up, which is nice. The Rumble 100 also has an effects loop built into the back of it, something that the Rumble 40, and I guess you could say 40 and below, doesn't have. One cool feature of these new series is they're also super light, which you can kind of tell by, I'm semi-strong, well, I'm not really that strong anyway, but you can pick them up very easily. So I'll put this one down and I will now also show you this other cool feature that if for whatever reason you want to get in and have a look at the speaker, you can do so just by taking the front grill off. Flip it around, have a look at the back. The aforementioned effects loop is there. Auxiliary input to play along with. Headphone output so you don't annoy the neighbors. Foot switch input. The line output, so there's DI out with a ground lift as well. If you've got some dirty power or any bad noises. Thanks for watching. I'm Reese from Cranbourne Music. Come in and check out the Rumble series of amplifiers version 3 from Fender today. Bye.